another shit day at work. My boss is still pissing me right off. Dickhead. I'd leave, but I'm saving up to open my own clothes shop one day. Can't wait to find the right place. Do it up. Get loads of really nice gear, you know? I'm packing this shit show they call media telly sales. God, I hate this life. I'd die if it wasn't for my weekends. I'm gonna meet up with everyone in the pub first. I leave the flat about 10. And not before I do half a bottle of vodka and Red Bull. And a couple of pills, of course. And I'm on my way. I'm right on my way. By the time I get there, I'm already sweating. See the lads at the bar, and Michelle, and her mates in the corner, and I make out like I ain't seen her. Like I don't give a fuck. But I do really. And everyone's talking about going over the shortage, seeing whether all players are mental techno thing. So I said I'd go as well. We jump on the bus with a lot from the wheat sheaf. Michelle goes and sits three or four rows ahead. And we make eye contact. Again and again and again. It ain't like we don't like each other. It's just difficult, you know, being in a group and all that. But tonight it's different. I can't stop looking for her when she goes out of view. She seems like she's doing the same. And her mates look like she's getting on their nerves. Good. So we all eventually get off the bus and walk up towards the warehouse. And just past the rough trade shop, my hand brushes past hers lightly as she gently grabs my little finger. Once we get into the club, I buy her a drink. I can't hear a word she says, so we just shout in each other's ears for a while. Her breath feels warm and heavy and sweet on my neck. So we drop the plastic beakers on the PA bins and we start to dance. And we start kissing. And her hands are all around my back and my neck. Myself getting harder and harder and harder as she pushes herself up against me, and her mouth tastes like garlic, and I love it. We go outside for a fag and to do another couple of pills. Well, I don't know how we got back to mine, but when I wake up, it's the next day. It's about 2:30 in the afternoon, and the place is a mess. All my vinyls on the floor, out the sleeves, and there's pillows and sofa cushions all over the place. It smells like fag bus. But she's gone and left her bag. I find her mobile, her keys, and her purse in it. And I play back last night like a film. And I try to remember what happened. Then suddenly she comes out the bathroom. And she asks if we can put the kettle on. And I say, yeah, of course. And I do it. And she suggests we go over the canal for a walk. And I tell her I'm up for it. I tell her I'm really up for it. But she knows. knows anyway.